Hi, this is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. This is the last game from the Steinitz-Zukertort match, played in 1886. Steinitz had white pieces and he started with e4. Zukertort played e5. Knight to c3, intending f4, and the Vienna game. Knight to c6, f4, the Vienna game. Pawn takes pawn on f4. White to move. d4 was played. Knight to f3 is the most played move, preventing queen to h4. d4 by Steinitz. d5. E takes on d5. If e5, then queen to h4 check, and after king to e2, bishop to g4 check, and after knight to f3, g5. Black is doing well. Back to our game. E takes on d5, attacking the knight. Queen to h4 check. King to e2. Queen to e7 check. King to f2. Queen to h4. g3. F takes on g3 check. King to g2. Black to move. Knight takes on d4 was played. If g takes on h2, then rook takes on h2, attacking the queen. And after queen takes on d4, d takes on c6. And after queen takes queen, knight takes queen, white is better. Back to our game. So we have knight takes on d4. H takes on g3, attacking the queen. Queen to g4. Queen to e1, check. Bishop to e7. Bishop to d3. Black to move. Knight to f5 was played. King to f8 should have been considered. Knight to f5. Knight to f3. Bishop to d7. Black is intending to castle queen's side. Bishop to f4. It is black to move. f6 was played. Why Zukertort didn't castle queen's side? What would you do in this position? If you had white pieces, please pause and find the best move for white. If black castled queenside, then knight to e5 and black queen is trapped. Back to our game. To prevent knight to e5, f6 was played. Knight to e4. Nice move. Steinitz is predicting that Zukertort will play knight to h6. Knight from G to H6, this developing move looks quite natural, but it is a blunder. Why? What would you do in this position if you had white pieces? Steinitz played bishop takes on H6, knight takes bishop. Why to move? How would you continue now? Steinitz sacrificed the exchange. Pawn takes rook. And the reason for the exchange sacrifice is now obvious, isn't it? And the move is knight takes on f6 check, forking the king and the queen. King to f8. Knight takes on g4. And Zukertort resigned. Altogether, these players played 20 games in this match. Steinitz won 10 games, Zukertort won 5, and 5 games ended in a draw. So after this game, Steinitz became the first ever world chess champion. What do you think of this game?
And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.